Michel Tiako of the Ivory Coast in four. Then Bruce Wayne of Australia in five. David Kitter of Kenya in lane six. Lishad of Zambia in seven. And Uti of Nigeria in lane eight. So Antonio Mackay has made it clear he doesn't even want to lose in the semi-final. But Cameron is flowing, and so too is Frayne of Australia, who run 45-3-2. Cameron's in trouble and pulled out. He's pulled up and he started again. He really had a hamstring and he's gone on again. And Cameron in trouble in lane two. Elvis fought his way inside him and he's coming again. That is extraordinary, because at 120 metres he was in trouble. He stopped, and now he and the American are both in trouble, as Tiako takes the lead from Frayne. And Cameron's coming through, and so is Mackay, but Uti's up there, and Tiako, Uti, the American, and Cameron got through. That was truly astonishing. Look at him holding his leg. He came back for nowhere. He stopped the race. It was Antonio Mackay that was lost for speed, but this man, Bert Cameron, the world champion, directly opposite us at 120 metres, practically stopped. That is extraordinary. If it's cramp, well, it may be through salt loss and sweating, but he was lost and gone forever. And that was a truly extraordinary race. Let's just have a look at this again, because round the first bend, Cameron look in the yellow and green. Watch him, he's got Ford in white, he's got Mackay, and he appears to have overtaken Mackay. Now watch this, there he is. Look, he's jumped up in the air, both arms are up in the air, and he practically stops. He practically stops, his arms are up in the air again, he's clearly cramped up, and one would have thought he would have walked off. He's holding the back of his thigh, suddenly decides he can go on. Look at the gap that's been created. And he changes his mind and suddenly starts to chase the pack. Bert Cameron from Spanish Town, Jamaica. The poor boy who's made it big, the world champion and the 82 Commonwealth champion. He now starts and gradually unwinds, picks his knees up again. He's stretching himself to feel whether it can possibly come back. He's yards back off the pace. Now he's suddenly got Mackay. And remember, Mackay was running badly compared to Ford and Tiako and Uti. And suddenly he's back in the race and he has a look at what's possible. He hauls himself past Elvis Ford. And this is truly astonishing. He gets up to Mackay and he's going to finish and he's going to be in the final to meet Mackay again as he hits the line there and makes it in fourth place. That is rare indeed.
This is a journey for Cathy.